Hello everyone, today we are going to see about the minimum cost spanning tree in data structure. So if you want to know about the graph, you have to see the previous videos about the graph. Today we are going to see about minimum cost spanning tree. First we should know what is spanning tree. It's just a subset of a graph G where all the vertices should be connected with minimum possible number of edges. So you know what is the meaning of edge. It is just a connection between any of the two vertices. So hence this spanning tree should not have any cycles like a loop, and also it should not have any disconnected nodes. Here I have given one example which is called the graph G. It's having three vertices A, B and C, and which is connected internally. Here I have given the spanning trees of that graph. Here A, B and C is connected, but there is no loop. So spanning tree means it should have minimum number of connection, but all the nodes should be connected. Here I have taken A, B, C. So I have removed one connection between A to C. Similarly this also. So this is a spanning tree. All the nodes should be connected somehow, but there should not be any loop. So a complete undirected graph can have maximum of n power n minus 2 number of spanning trees. Here it is a 3 node graph, so it should have 3 power 3 minus 2 nodes, where 3 will be the answer. So it is having minimum 3 possible number of spanning trees. So mathematical properties I have given. This tree has n minus 1 edges where n is the number of nodes. So this is called n minus 1 edge. Edge means you know it's a connection. Then it is having n power n minus 2 number of spanning trees. So we have from this we are concluding that it is a subset of a connected graph G and it is disconnected. It should not have disconnected graphs in the spanning tree. So application of spanning tree is basically, practically it is used in so many applications. So I have given very few: network routing protocol, then network planning, then cluster analysis. Practically if you will see for plan of telephone lines, when they want to deploy the telephone lines, that way this minimum cost spanning tree algorithm will be used. So we can connect all the city nodes. Here this is the application of the spanning tree, or more applications are there. Here in this minimum cost spanning tree, this connections, that is that edges, is having some weight or cost. We are telling that is a cost. This cost may be anything like distance, congestion, traffic, or any of the transmission speed of that data. It may be anything, that cost may be, so we cannot tell that. If you take the example of the last graph, if you want to connect some telephone line with that, there may be in A and B node if you are connecting, and if there is no traffic in that route, then A to B and B to C is a good connection. That minimum spanning tree is good. In case if that A to B edge is having more clients, then it will be having more traffic. In that case you can choose A to C node for minimum cost spanning tree. So depend upon our we can just create the minimum spanning tree based on the application. So this one more application, Google Map, everybody is using. So every time you are just noting the updated news of traffic. So using this also, we can using this minimum cost spanning tree also used in these kind of Google Map applications. And this minimum spanning tree is having some algorithms which is called Prim's algorithm and Kruskal's algorithm. Few more also there. So in next video we will be seeing what is Prim's algorithm and what is Kruskal's algorithm and how to do minimum cost spanning tree using that algorithm. We can see that. Thank you.